Good morning everyone, Leah here. So today we are going to do another skincare ingredient series and today we're going to take a closer look at the vitamin A family, which is retinoic acid and retinols. Now it is no doubt that vitamin A family is definitely the royal family when it comes to active ingredients. There are no other active ingredients that can really overdo what vitamin A can do. It's such a hot topic and I'm seeing a lot of new products containing new forms of retinol or retinoic acid, and there's a lot of confusion because there's not a lot of education around this retinol or what it does, what the benefits are, what the side effects are. So today I compiled all of the information that I researched into this video, so please give it a like if you trust me and you know it's gonna be good, and let's get started. When it comes to vitamin A, you have to remember tretinoin. This is the purest form of vitamin A, or I would say it's the most biocompatible form, which means that our skin just receives tretinoin without any conversion, without any hesitation, and as soon as you apply this tretinoin, it will work right away. Now let's start from the history of tretinoin, how it all happened. It all happened back in 1960s, and there were two doctors named Dr. Fulton and Dr. Klickman. Okay, Mrs. Yu, you seem like you're doing well. How's your acne going with the tretinoin? It improved so much thanks to you, but I also wanted to talk to you about something that's been happening to my skin. What do you mean? I don't know if I'm dreaming, but my skin is smoother and I'm turning 52 this year, but I've never looked this wrinkleless and youthful, and I feel like I just revived from youth. Your skin does seem better and more youthful. And you haven't used anything for tretinoin? Mm-mm. You're not in a new relationship, didn't go to a yoga retreat, or you didn't add any supplements or anything? Just the tretinoin you gave me. Wow. You know what? I gotta go. These two doctors were treating acne patients with this tretinoin because it has anti-inflammatory, anti-acne properties, and they started noticing something really irregular. Other than just treating acne, the patients reported to have less wrinkles, smoother skin, and more firm and just bouncy, healthier skin. So they reported to Food and Drug Administration, FDA. And since then, FDA admitted that tretinoin can be used to reverse signs of aging, reverse photo damage, and tretinoin still remains the single ingredient that is approved by FDA as an active ingredient to reverse signs of aging. So it is sort of a big deal. Now, the reason why tretinoin or the all-trans retinoic acid works so well on our skin is that it works on a skin cellular level. Retinoic acids are more like a butt kicker to our skin cells. Our skin cells get lazy and it does slow down over time by biological aging or other external stressors. So vitamin A can definitely help your skin cells to behave in a normal and a healthy way. That's because our skin cells have a retinoic acid receptors, which means that it has a girlfriend and it's just waiting for its significant other to come home, and then it'll just match perfectly. What are the skin benefits of retinoic acid? First and foremost, there's anti-aging benefits or graceful aging benefits. It not only inhibits the collagen from breaking down, but it also promotes the collagen synthesis, which means that you're gonna have a bouncier, healthier skin. A lot of other active ingredients have a lot of limitations in producing and promoting more collagen because first, it might not be able to penetrate deeply to work in the level where it can actually promote the collagen production, and B, it might not even inhibit the collagen breakdown. So that's why retinoic acid is called the queen or the gold standard of anti-aging. The second benefit is that retinoic acids can make your epidermis thicker, which means that your skin is going to be firmer and a lot bouncier. It's just going to have a good texture. This is achieved by a lot of multiple different factors that it does inside our skin. It also promotes other skin elements to build more. The skin building blocks such as the skin proteins and the natural moisturizing factors. Retinoic acid is able to really trigger them to promote more so that your skin is all around just youthful and bouncy. Number three, anti-acne benefits. As we learned in the history class, we learned that tretinoin was first developed to treat acne patients. It does it by normalizing the keratinization, which basically means that it just prevents dead skin cells from clogging and sticking together, so it doesn't clog the pore. It naturally sheds dead skin cells, which also means that it does have a certain degree of exfoliating property. It can also regulate the sebum production, and also it will unclog the pore and keep your pore tunnel really nice and clean. It also has a skin brightening property, especially targeting those stubborn sunspots, sun damage, hyperpigmentation, and the discoloration that you have here and there. It's not going to be as effective as using hydroquinone, which is another over-the-counter drug active ingredient that is solely used to lightening those spots, but it still helps to a certain degree. I know that you might want to go out right now to buy the tretinoin or get a prescription for tretinoin, but I want you guys to be very aware of what the downsides are. This ingredient just seems too good to be true, but definitely there are some side effects or some things that you really want to be aware of before starting your tret journey. The most common symptoms are irritation, skin flaking, excessive dryness, and also redness and purging. And it also seems that tretinoin can temporarily increase the transepidermal water loss, which happens when your skin barrier is disrupted. So I would highly recommend you to supplement with a really nice moisturizer that contains ceramides, cholesterol, and free fatty acids, or use in conjunction with a lot of beautiful facial oils to help rebuild the skin barrier. Also, when you're on a tretinoin or when you're using any kinds of vitamin A or any other active ingredients or every day, you really need to be diligent in applying sunscreen. You're creating all this effort to reveal the healthier skin, but once the skin is damaged by UV ray, you're just reversing every effort that you've done. So make sure that you apply a really good amount of sunscreen every single day. We learned about retinoic acid. Now, there's something called retinol. The biggest difference is that tretinoin or retinoic acid is a prescription drug. So you need to go to your doctor who understands your skin's history, and they'll prescribe you the right dosage, the right potency of tretinoin. Whereas retinol is a over-the-counter drug, which is readily available. You can get it without any consent or prescription. You can get it from Sephora, and all the skincare brands can readily use this in their formulation. So think retinol as a cousin or a sister of retinoic acid and tretinoin. Because it's the cousin, it is not going to be as effective as retinoic acid. In theory, our skin needs to process and digest retinol to transfer and convert that into retinoic acid to make it work on their skin. But your skin may be lazy, or the delivery system and the formulation might not be ideal to penetrate into the skin. So not all of the retinol that you're applying is going to work right away. Hi. Name? Retinoic acid. Retinoic acid. You're a citizen. You can just go in. Okay. Hi. Name? Retinol? Retinol, why are you here? I just need to deliver this anti-aging package to my client inside. It is a little bit tricky right now. I'm probably gonna let 40% of you guys in, and I can't guarantee all of those packages that you brought will be delivered to the client, okay? Otherwise, you're all set. Thank you so much for your help. My first retinol product was the Ordinary Retinol 1%, and that product irritated my skin so terribly. My skin was so red and so severely damaged. It was peeling like crazy. So don't think that retinol doesn't have all these irritation or side effects just because it's the over-the-counter cosmetics product. It certainly does have it. The interesting thing about skincare industry is that when there's an irritation or a downside of some sort of really, really good ingredient, they will find an alternative solution. So there are a lot of great new ingredients that are really, really promising that acts like a retinoic acid, but it's more like a sister version that is milder and more gentle. That's how I came across HPR. So HPR is definitely a new member to the royal family, and I think the queen will definitely welcome this princess because it is really, really talented. It has little to no irritation, and it just works really, really well because unlike retinol or retinol palmitate, which is another type of vitamin A, it requires no conversion at all. It is a retinoic acid ester, which means that it's just like a sister product of retinoic acid, the tretinoin. As we all know now, our skin has a receptor that receives retinoic acid, and the HPR binds to this receptor right away, working just magically and beautifully without any conversion. So that's why it's so exciting and very, very promising. Based on the manufacturer's study, it says that after doing a 24 hours occlusive patch test with 0.5% of HPR versus 0.5% of retinol, the HPR side had significantly lower irritation. And I can definitely attest to that conclusion. It is really, really gentle. But again, since this is such a new ingredient, there's not a lot of research or a double-blinded study from the peer-reviewed articles, biased studies that are done by the manufacturers, because manufacturers need to sell this retinoic acid to all the beauty brands out there. But hopefully in the coming years, there will be more research backing up with good solid evidence about the efficacy of this HPR ingredient. There's another new up-and-coming ingredient that you might want to know, and that is called Bakuchiol. And I love this cute name. Basically, this is an active compound that is extracted from the seed of the bakuchi plant. And nowadays, we call this a plant-based cousin to the royal family. It's very interesting because Bakuchiol has nothing to do with retinoic acid or any sorts of vitamin A. However, the way it works on top of our skin and in our skin is very similar to the mechanism of retinoic acid. The biggest similarity is that it inhibits the collagen breakdown, and it also promotes the collagen production, which is amazing for anti-aging. In fact, they did a comparison study of retinol cream and bakuchiol cream, and the bakuchiol cream didn't have any irritation or a significantly low amount of irritation. Another good news is that it also has anti-acne benefits. So for those guys who are using retinoic acid or retinol or any sorts of vitamin A for anti-acne purpose, bakuchiol can be another alternative, or it can work synergistically with retinol and also salicylic acid. One study shows that 1% of bakuchiol significantly reduced the acne lesion. The results were even better when it combined with 2% of salicylic acid. It works by regulating the sebum productions, and it also acts as a really wonderful anti-inflammatory ingredient, just lowering and regulating the overall skin inflammation. It also has a lot of antioxidant benefits, which prevents your lipid, the oil on top of your skin, from oxidizing. And let me know if you guys want something from Crave Beauty to contain any of these ingredients. I think it is very, very fun, but also at the same time, we're taking our time to research everything, all aspects of the ingredients. Q&A time. When is the right time to start vitamin A? Now, there's really no right answer to this because everyone has different process of biological aging and they have a different lifestyle. And it seems like though, generally, a lot of dermatologists would recommend you to use retinol in your late 20s or early 30s, which is basically my age group. If you are in your teenage years, I would highly recommend you to consult with your doctor, because a lot of times acne can be managed by using tretinoin, adapalene, or other vitamin A derivatives. How do you start incorporating retinoids or retinol in your routine? It's going to be a little bit different if you're starting from prescription retinoid or tretinoin. I would definitely recommend you to consult with your doctor. But if you're starting from the over-the-counter retinol, bakuchiol, and HPR and other forms of retinol, I would definitely recommend you to start with the lowest concentration that's available, and preferably HPR or bakuchiol, because it doesn't have a lot of irritation. And use it at night, probably once or twice a week to begin with, and baby step into it. It's very, very important to monitor the progress and how your skin responds and reacts to the certain ingredient. It may or may not work for you, so don't get your hopes too high. One thing to really remember while using retinol is to moisturizing deliberately, using sunscreen diligently. A lot of you guys asked for my product recommendations, but I'm gonna save that to another video after trialing a lot of more retinol products. But I will still list all the product that I can find that contains all the ingredients that I mentioned today. Another interesting thing to note, or something that I really wanted to talk about, was the difference between Korean skincare and American skincare. In Korea, it's very, very hard to find a product that contains retinol. So I asked a lot of formulators and researchers and chemists here in Korea, and we came to a conclusion that since in the States side, it's so expensive to visit the dermatologist. Even getting the prescription tretinoin requires you to have a couple hundred bucks. That's why the beauty industry in America is so focusing on delivering the highest percentage of retinol to give you a more transformative result. Whereas in Korea, visiting a doctor is so cheap. Going to a dermatologist is not a big deal. If someone's concern is aging, they would go to the dermatologist to get the laser treatment and $50. So the mass population of Koreans tend to have lower expectation from skincare products to deliver a transformative result. If anything, Koreans expect the skincare products to be really regenerative, restorative, and repair a really stressed out or irritated skin. So it's much more focused on hydrating and nourishing. I thought that was a very interesting difference in context that just influences the difference in the beauty industry. And I'm so sorry about the background noise. I'm filming in a studio that I rented, but there is a lot of people on that side of the wall. Please make sure to share this video if you found this helpful, and let me know if you guys want me to continue doing this ingredient series. I'll talk to you guys later, and until then, take care.